there, everybody. Welcome back to Full Circle with Joyce. Time now for our next segment. And we want to talk about talents and gifts and how to actually be able to multitask when you're holding different talents and multiple gifts. It can sometimes get overwhelming, I can tell you that for sure, but it is possible to do it and to do it well. And so here in studio with me, I have Edward Nyanaro, who's the founder of 254 Talent Management. Karibu sana to the show.
Thank you very much for having me, Joyce.
You're most welcome. We want to talk about how to utilize all of our gifts. And of course, there's that same that we can be a jack of all trades and a master of none. And I think for people who are multi-talented, that always is a struggle. It's always a tension that am I splitting myself too far? Am I splitting my time too thin to be able to actually do these things well? Now, speaking of time, you are actually an actor, you're an MC, you're a commercial model, you're a voiceover artist, you're a fitness enthusiast, and here you are also running this business, 254 Talent Management. So I'm so glad that I get to ask this question to a guy, because I hate it when it's only asked to women. How do you balance? I really hate that question, because guys do it too. But anyway, how do you balance? This is my opportunity to ask it.
You know, balance is something that comes with a priority. So you prioritize your time. You know, you have so many things to do, but what should come first? You know, that's one thing that I learned over time. It was not easy. It's not like I'm perfect at balancing stuff. But over time, I have learned that you need to prioritize your time and see what is important, what is urgent, what is what comes second, and then time management really works when that comes into play, because you cannot be in two locations at the same time. You have to decide, are you gonna be here or you're gonna be there? And in what I do, it got to a moment where I couldn't balance well, and I was giving more attention to my talent, my models and actors, that I wasn't giving attention to myself. And I reminded myself, I'm also talent. So I needed to have someone to take care of my talent as well. So I signed up with an agent, you know, in a modeling agency. And I also signed up with a voice acting agent, so that they also look out for my interest. So as far as in the company is concerned, I have to have my own time that I do my recreation. I need to find time, and you do my fitness. I have to find time when it's for casting, you know. If I'm in an acting gig, I need to schedule my time properly and know between this time and this time I'm going to be available for this. You know,
and and speaking of being a jack of all trades, I want us to talk about that for a moment. Being a jack of all trades and a master of none is a common adage. And how do you reconcile that with your life then? Because these are obviously very many things that you're doing. And at what point, as much as you're prioritizing and you're, you know, doing what you need to do such you have that balance, at what point is it that we are doing too much? And at what point should we sort of create a cap for ourselves and say, okay, this year I'm only going to focus on these three things, or, you know, for this, you know, next quarter I'm only going to do two things. How, I think that's part of prioritizing. It's also prioritizing the time that will be devoted. So at what point is too much? Is it too much? And now we're just kind of everywhere.
I understand. There's a time I used to sing. So I sang for like around 9 years, and it was amazing. So I had to come from work and go for music practice, and then weekends we could be performing, you know, in weddings and all that. And then I was thinking, this is affecting my business in a sense, because then I have to give this time. And over time I decided, you know, I need to take a break on that and give more attention to my company and my personal growth, so that I can be able to balance well. Because you cannot be able to do everything perfectly and not be able to make a hitch if you're if you don't give it enough time. So that's one thing that I noticed. So I had to put aside music to be able to focus on these others. And With regards to commercial modeling or of management of my company, all these things started happening in different years. It's not something I didn't start all this at the same time, you know? So like back in 2007 is when I started commercial modeling. And it's now 13 years since that happened. And
So are you actively doing all of these things now?
Actively doing all these things now. Right now, I'm not on a TV show, so I'm not acting. Yeah. So, but it does not make me less of an actor. But if a project comes in, I can be able to do that. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I haven't been emceeing for a while, but it's something that I have done before. And I've done that for films, and I have done that Lola film screening.
Okay.
And I've also done it for corporates.
Okay.
Yeah. As for voiceovers, I do it actively.
Okay.
It's something that I have now given priority right now more than acting, because I'm not on set.
All right.
So voiceovers for voice on holds, documentaries, TV commercials, you know, and
so
I do scripting.
There are seasons
to all this, you know, because for TV commercials, it depends on clients and advertising agencies when they have work.
Sure.
Yeah.
Okay. Mm. Now, of course, you know, in doing all of these things, most people would be doing this, you know, it would be great to earn a substantial living from what we do and the things that we apply our time to. Mm. And I guess that brings me to the point about hustling. And like, because a lot of us, you know, we talk about, maze, hustle, bana, hustle, this country, economy, nimbaya, nini, nini, COVID. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Is that how you look at what you do? And is that the right mentality for those who are trying to juggle different skills and talents, and they're really just trying to find a place that would work? So they know that they're talented with different gifts and things, but you know, sometimes you just have to keep knocking on very many doors. Is that how you would sort of encourage one to view their giftings and to chase them?
Totally not. This is not hustling. For a fact, because one thing is, I used to be employed before. Okay. I have worked in different fields before, from insurance. I have worked in a hotel for hotel booking reservations. Mm-hmm. I've worked in a call center before, and the one that I came from was media, Radio Africa, where I was dealing with advertising. So, coming from all these backgrounds, before I set out to do what I do consistently and decide that this is what I want, it came from purpose. It came from that passion that I decided I need to commit to arts and let this, you know, it gives me fulfillment.
Right.
Yeah. And from the fulfillment, I also get to make money. Mm-hmm. So entertainment business, part of it. Mm-hmm. So I would appreciate it if people take it seriously. Because it's not just a thing that you do when you have time.
Right.
Yeah. It is something that you commit to, you build it up, and you start earning from it, and you have a business aspect to it.
Right.
Yeah. So that's how I view it.
And that's and that's good. That's fair enough. And I think also part of the caveat, I guess, for those, you know, wanting to dive into the creative industry, it's the thing about the creative industry is that it can be very fickle, right? Because you see the highlights of it on social media, but it's not always like that. In fact, many times those highlights are very few and far between.
Yes.
And so if you're not doing it because it's something that you're really passionate about, that you're chasing purpose, that you're chasing, you know, you really want to have impact, you're going to be quite frustrated. And thank goodness, I mean, people are making a living and income through creative arts and, you know, those fields, but it can be tough.
It is tough.
And so if you're in there with the wrong motives,
exactly,
you're going to be frustrated. But I want us to also talk about skills, because sometimes, like you said, even for you, there's seasons. And sometimes it's also that maybe one never had the opportunity to express themselves in a creative way. And you tend to see, especially after college or even high school, they just want some time to really figure out themselves, figure out exactly what they want. But maybe later on, they see themselves, you know, looking for some sort of job or starting a business, whatever it could be. I want us to talk about the different skills that one can you know, build and harness, or should be building and harnessing, you know, as they sort of pursue a very creative lifestyle and, you know, career path. Because I'm certain that there are certain skills that you've picked up along the way, from emceeing, from voiceovers to whatever it is. So maybe let's talk about that, because those are the things that I think even a future employer or a future business partner would be looking out for.
Yeah, so I think it is important from anything that you do, like from the myriad of experiences I've had in different companies, it has built to who I am today. You know, the experience, the customer service experience, the sales part, sales and marketing aspect of it, the skills that I have acquired, like, okay, do you know how to drive? You know, at times in a TV commercial, you're asked to drive or swim or some skill that you have acquired, you know? Also, can you sing? You know, if you're in a musical or, you know, all those things. So it is important to have an attend workshops, you know, voice classes. We have Voice Actors League of Kenya. We usually have workshops. Attend acting workshops as well. You know, that improves your acting skills.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do photo shoots that creative, you know, that show different expressions of joy, shock, sadness, and all that that can be used in a commercial, you know. Interact with people who are in the industry. You get to have experience from them, you know, and learn the business, you know. That is important. And when you get all these platforms, like we offer mentorship for up-and-coming talent, and also in our pool for voicing, for runway, for different talents. So we can be able to, you know, get into these things, and they will build your skill, and over time you will realize, yeah, okay, I'm good at this, I could improve on this and all that.
Okay. Well, Valerie from Chogoria watching the show has an interesting comment saying, I'm enjoying the show today, and I want to say that multitasking is well done by the female gender compared to the male gender. I'm not being biased, but few men can actually multitask and give it their best. Well, I'm going to give you the chance to to address that.
It is true. Multitasking is not for many. Like, I cannot talk and text at the same time. I've seen ladies do that, you know. But with what I do, because I'm passionate about it and I give time to it, it's also important to have a team so that you're not doing everything by yourself. You know, it can be overwhelming, you know, to say by the least.
But I guess that's another struggle, because you've talked about having an agent for your voiceovers, an agent for, was it acting or modeling?
Voiceover and commercial modeling.
And commercial modeling. And here you are talking about a team. And I think for a lot of people, when they're starting out, they're just like, I've not even been paid anything. How am I going to afford, you know, all of these people? So how does one sort of go about being able to establish that team when they're just starting out?
When you're starting out, it is important to just show what you have. What skills, what talents do you have? And people tend to acknowledge that. And if I'm seeing you're very good at voicing, I'd want to work with you, you know? And if you're in the right platforms, you know, even WhatsApp groups, just start from there, you know? Get information from there. And then, you can be able to, you can be able to grow it, you know. But you have to just showcase your talent to the right circles, and then you'll get the attention. If you also need to sign up with an agency, it is important to do research, see what they do, is it relevant to what you're doing, and then join them. You know, sign up, start up, and do some mentorship and all that, and then get into the industry with a lot of knowledge, with not ignorance at all, because a lot of people can take advantage of young and up and coming talent, and you know, just either extort money from them, con them, and all that, which we want to avoid.
Okay.
You know.
All right. Wow, Edward, thank you very much for coming on to the show today and just telling us a bit about yourself and how you've gone about exploring different fields of your career. We really do appreciate it. And hopefully that's of encouragement to other people as well who are seeking to have a very creative career path, that it is possible. You just have to put your mind and your heart to it, you know, the money to the metal, and really work on it. And I want to very quickly put you on the spot just a little bit and ask you to do like a voiceover, like if you were to do a voiceover for a promo of this show, what would you say? How would you do it?
You're watching Full Circle with Joyce.
Wow.
Tune in to Switch TV. Watch. Yeah, something like that. You know, off the head.
Okay.
Yeah.
So do you have to like think of that voice? I don't know how to say that in English.
You have to, it has to come from here.
Okay.
And you can scribble something kidogo and then try and have a smile on.
Okay.
So that helps with the projection.
All right.
Yes.
Can you tell people we'll be back on this camera? Tell them we'll be back at the top of the hour. Keep watching.
We'll be back top of the hour. Keep watching.
I could listen to that all day. Thank you so much, Edward, for coming onto the show. Guys, we're going to take a break. We'll be back at the top of the hour.